Of the Archdiocese of San Antonio. He became the rector of this very house and was ordained as Bishop of San Bernardino in 1992. If we combine the time he served in the Diocese of San Bernardino, his time is longer than Pope John Paul II in the papacy, 28 years, 3 years as an auxiliary, and 25 years as the ordinary of San Bernardino. His love and support for Assumption, tremendous. And on behalf of the seminary and many generations that went through this seminary, some of them here, actually one member who is in the formator, the faculty staff at this moment, was a student when he was a rector here. So talking about the good connection and the love that Bishop Barnes gave to us, Assumption Seminary. His motto is very significant. Love is the total giving of oneself. Bishop, you have given all your love to San Bernardino for 28 years, and you have given your love to Assumption vocation in general and to the church. So on behalf of all, thank you.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
La paz del Señor esté con ustedes.
Y con ustedes.
Buenos días. Good morning to you. We gather in this chapel of Assumption Seminary to thank Almighty God for the gift of the priesthood. Men are here studying, having heard God's call to follow Him as priests of our respective dioceses. And so our prayers are of gratitude to God for calling these men and for those that have supported this seminary and those that support their vocations. We are to live always in gratitude. But we also know that at times our lives don't indicate our gratitude to God. At times we live in anger and we want more and more, are not grateful for what God has given us in blessings. Así es que para escuchar de nuevo la palabra del Señor y aceptar la invitación a la mesa de Jesús, vamos a confesar que no somos dignos, pero que confiamos en la misericordia del Señor. Let us call to mind our sins and ask for God's mercy.
Yo confieso ante Dios
Gloria a Dios en el cielo y en la tierra a los hombres que da el Señor. Glorifica en la mayor es gloria y tu gran.
Dios nuestro, que enseñaste a los ministros de tu iglesia a no buscar ser servidos, sino a servir a sus hermanos, concédenos disponibilidad en la entrega, mansedumbre en el servicio y la perseverancia en la oración. O God, you have taught the ministers of your church to seek not to be served but to serve the brothers and sisters. Grant, we pray, that they may be effective in action, gentle in ministry, and constant in prayer. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amén. Lectura del libro del Deuteronomio. En aquellos días, Moisés le dijo al pueblo: Escucha, Israel, los mandamientos del Señor y cúmplelos, para que te vaya bien, llegues a ser un pueblo numeroso, conforme a lo que te ha prometido el Señor, Dios de tus padres, quien te dará una tierra que mana leche y miel. Escucha, Israel, el Señor, nuestro Dios es solamente uno. Amarás el Señor tu Dios con todo tu corazón, con toda tu alma, con todas tus fuerzas. Graba en tu corazón los mandamientos que hoy te he transmitido. Incúlcaselos a tus hijos y háblales de ellos cuando estés en tu casa, o cuando vayas de camino, cuando te acuestes y cuando te levantes. Átalos a tu muñeca como una señal, y serán una señal en tu frente. Escríbelos sobre la puerta de tu casa. Palabra de Dios.
Oh. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The disciples devoted themselves to the teaching of the apostles and to the communal life, to the breaking of the bread and to the prayers. Awe came upon everyone, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their property and possessions and divide them among all according to each one's need. Every day they devoted themselves to meeting together in the temple area and to breaking bread in their homes. They ate their meals with exultation and sincerity of heart, praising God and enjoying favor with all the people. And every day the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus came to Nazareth, where he has grown up, and went according to his custom into the synagogue on the Sabbath day. He stood up to read and was handed the scroll of the prophet Isaiah. He unrolled the scroll and found the passage where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord." Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down, and the eyes of all in the synagogue look hiddenly at him. He said to them, "Today, this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." En aquel tiempo, Jesús fue a Nazaret, donde se había creado. Entró en la sinagoga como era su costumbre hacerlo los sábados, y se levantó para hacer la lectura. Se le dio el volumen del profeta Isaías, lo desenrolló y encontró el pasaje en que estaba escrito: El Espíritu del Señor está sobre mí, porque me ha ungido para llevar a los pobres la buena nueva, para anunciar la liberación a los cautivos y la curación a los ciegos, para dar libertad a los oprimidos y proclamar el año de gracia del Señor. Enrolló el volumen, lo devolvió al encargado y se sentó. Los ojos de todos los asistentes a la sinagoga estaban fijos en él. Entonces comenzó a hablar diciendo: Hoy mismo se ha cumplido este pasaje de la Escritura que ustedes acaban de oír. Palabra del Señor.
Gloria a ti, Señor Jesús.
Those to be instituted in the ministry of Lector, please stand as your name is called. From the Archdiocese of San Antonio, Stephen Fitz-Simon.
Present.
Rafael Becerra Gonzalez.
Present.
Omar Tobar Almasa.
Present.
From the Diocese of El Paso, Anwar Alfonso Camarena. From the Diocese of Fort Worth, Eric Flores.
Present.
From the Diocese of Laredo, Javier Morales.
Present.
Jose Antonio Perez.
Present.
Andres Pulgarín Cano.
Present.
From the Diocese of San Bernardino, Thomas Davis.
Present.
Alfredo Ledesma.
Present.
Jesús Rafael Murataya Omelas.
Present.
Please be seated. Those to be instituted in the ministry of Acolyte, please stand as your name is called. From the Archdiocese of San Antonio, David Chaco.
Present.
Jordan Milligan.
Present.
Adrian Salazar.
Present.
From the Diocese of El Paso, Ángel de Jesús Aguilar Ábalos.
Present.
From the Diocese of Fort Worth, Brandon Leclerc.
Present.
From the Diocese of Laredo, Jerry Gutierrez.
Present.
José Luis Restrepo Crispo.
Present.
From the Diocese of San Bernardino, Rafael Flores.
Present.
Jonathan Garcia.
Present.
Julián Plasencia Gómez.
Present.
Brian Rafael Rivas.
Present.
Please be seated.
Sharing a little bit of my history, but not what I do. And I just want to share one of the ministries that I have as a bishop that I enjoy the most is visiting the parishes for a formal pastoral visitation. or I spend 2 to 3 days in the parish and meet with certain groups, visit the sick, do some town hall meetings, meetings with youth, and so forth. And it's a very rewarding experience for me. Takes a lot of energy, takes a lot of time, but I get to know the people. And if there is a Catholic school, then an extra day is put on for liturgy with the student body and the staff, as well as visiting the classrooms and having a special time with the principal and with the staff. When I go into the 8th grade classroom, I'm generally accompanied in the visit to the school by the principal and by the superintendent of schools. And so the three of us go into the 8th grade, and the teacher's there, and everybody, you know, they're not the little ones that say, "Good morning, Bishop Barnes," you know, the little ones that sing song and thing. They say, "Good morning," and then I dismiss the superintendent, the principal, and the teacher. And I tell them, "You may leave now." And those 8th graders just look at me, "Wow, this guy's got power." I speak to them about the move that's taking place. They're leaving grade school, 8th grade. And many of them have been there since kindergarten. It's all that they've known. And then I kind of play with it and ask them, if I were married and I'd move into this community and looking for a good school for my children, why would I want to send them here to this school? And they began reflecting what is good about the school. But then I also tell them, if you saw the power that I have, I said, if I would hear what you want to change here, what would you change? And they open up and tell me that. But I do remind them that it's time for them to move on and things are going to be different. Some will go to different high schools, their friendships may be separated. But all that they also have received in the support of their teachers and the sacrifices of their parents and the attention that's been given to them. But it's time to move on. It's the next step. They have to continue to grow and have new opportunities of learning and discerning what their future may be. En toda la vida tenemos estos pasos. Tenemos estos pasos, los que van saliendo de las escuelas a otra escuela, tienen un tiempo de reflexionar un poco en lo que han recibido, y lo que les toca, y cómo van a hacer ese camino, cómo van a caminar hacia el futuro. Esos pasos son muy importantes, aunque para algunos de nosotros como adultos no se ven así. That same kind of step into the next place is what's happening today. You're being called from your dioceses and from your families to take the next step. It's time to take the next step. And it's time when we do that to do some reflection. What has happened that has brought me here? What have I learned? What opportunities have I really taken advantage of? And which ones I have put aside and failed to do that? This is part of your discernment. It may seem relatively minor. It's not ordination. It may seem relatively minor, but the church sees it as an important part in your discernment, in your calling towards what God wants you to do with your life. And so, even though it is minor, I ask you not to take it lightly. Something is happening, and it's time to reflect. It's time to give thanks. It's time to say, what else do I need to do? And time to move on. Time to move on. The church chooses these two ministries as an important part of your discernment process, an important part of your calling,
being lector, reader, and being an acolyte. The Holy Father, we were in Rome 18 days ago for our leaving of the bishops of Region 11. And the Holy Father spent 3 hours with us. 3 hours. And he shared with us some of his concerns. And one of his concerns was the formation of seminarians. He was very, very clear about that. And he said that the most important thing in being a diocesan seminarian is being close to the people, being with and for the people. That if that was not part of how you saw diocesan priesthood, that then maybe you're not being called to diocesan. Those were his very words. He says, as diocesan priesthood, there's a mission. And the mission is to be ministers to the people. And these steps that you're taking today, one as reader, puts you to that kind of office that brings you to proclaim the word of God to the people. To the people. To catechize and evangelize the people. And to do that, you need to walk with them, you need to accompany them. You need to know what is it that they need to hear, not what you think they should hear. It's that oneness with the people that this particular step or ministry kind of strengthens and gives you an official place in the church for proclaiming the word of God. And as acolyte, you're called to serve the people, especially the most vulnerable, the sick, the weak, the immigrant, the elderly, the castaways. You are to be that presence that we confess in the Mass, body and blood of the Lord. You're to be that presence of the Lord, his body, to the people of God. That's why these steps are very important. The Lord is calling you. Take time to discern, is this really your vocation? And if it is, go with it. Go with it. If it means you have to do some more reflecting, some more discerning, please do it. But never separate yourself from the people of God. Your calling is to be with them and for them. And that's what makes me happy about celebrating these particular ministries, because it's another step forward. You're not eighth graders. Even though maybe you might act on them. But you are men being called for service in the church, ministry to the people of God. You never forget that, because scripture is fulfilled today in your hearing. It is fulfilled today in your hearing. And so I'm very honored to represent your bishops in this particular celebration. Remember always to be united with your bishops. The Holy Father said something else. He said, sometimes the seminarians and even younger priests are so critical of the church and so critical of their bishops, so they need to ask themselves, is this what God is calling me to? Because we are to be united to our church, united with our bishops. It was a strong message from the Holy Father. So don't kill the messenger. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
to be instituted to the ministry of Lector, please come forward.
My dear sons in Christ, through his Son who became man for us, God the Father has revealed the mystery of salvation and brought it to fulfillment. Jesus Christ made all things known to us and then entrusted the Church with the mission of preaching the gospel to the whole world. As lectors and bearers of God's word, you will assist in this mission. And so take on a special office within the Christian community. You will be given a responsibility in the service of the faith, which is rooted in the Word of God. You will proclaim that Word in the liturgical assembly, instruct children and adults in the faith, and prepare them to receive the sacraments worthily. You will bring the message of salvation to those who have not yet received it. Thus, with your help, men and women will come to know God, God our Father and His Son, Jesus Christ, whom He sent, and so be able to reach eternal life. Cuando anuncien a otros la palabra de Dios, sean dóciles al Espíritu Santo. Ustedes mismos reciban esa palabra, mediten con diligencia, para que progresivamente vayan adquiriendo el suave y vivo afecto a la palabra divina, y que su vida dé testimonio de nuestro Salvador Jesucristo. I invite everyone to please stand.
Amados hermanos y hermanas, roguemos a Dios Padre Todopoderoso para que se digne bendecir a estos hijos suyos elegidos para el ministerio de lector, para que solícitos en el oficio que hoy les confía, predicando a Cristo, glorifiquen al Padre Celestial. En silencio oremos por estos hermanos. Lord God, source of all goodness and light, you sent your only Son, the Word of life, to reveal to mankind the mystery of your love. Bless our brothers who have been chosen for the ministry of Lector. Grant that as they meditate constantly on your Word, they may grow in its wisdom and faithfully proclaim it to your people. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
You may be seated.
Stephen, take this book of Holy Scripture and be faithful in handing on the Word of God so that it may grow strong in the hearts of His people.
Recibe el libro de la Sagrada Escritura y transmite fielmente la palabra de Dios para que sea más viva y eficaz en el corazón de los fieles.
Continuando. Recibe el libro de la Sagrada Escritura y transmite fielmente la palabra de Dios para que sea más viva y eficaz en el corazón de los fieles.
Alma, recibe el libro de la Sagrada Escritura y transmite fielmente la palabra de Dios para que sea más viva y eficaz en el corazón de los fieles.
Eric, take this book of Holy Scripture and be faithful and hand it on the Word of God, so that it may grow strong in the hearts of His people.
Amen.
Javier, recibe el libro de la Sagrada Escritura y transmite fielmente la palabra de Dios para que sea más viva y eficaz en el corazón de los fieles. José Antonio, recibe el libro de la Sagrada Escritura y transmite fielmente la palabra de Dios para que sea más viva y eficaz en el corazón de los fieles. Andrés, recibe el libro de la Sagrada Escritura y transmite fielmente la palabra de Dios para que sea más viva y eficaz en el corazón de los fieles. Take this book of Holy Scripture and be faithful in handing on the Word of God so that it may grow strong in the hearts of His people. Alfredo, recibe el libro de la Sagrada Escritura y transmite fielmente la palabra de Dios para que sea más viva y eficaz en el corazón de los fieles. Jesús, take this book of Holy Scripture and be faithful and hand it on the Word of God, so that it may grow strong in the hearts of His people. Let us congratulate our brothers.
Those to be instituted in the ministry of Acolyte, please come forward.
Amados hijos,
elegidos para el ministerio de apóstoles, desde ahora participarán de un modo particular en las celebraciones litúrgicas de la Iglesia, celebraciones que tienen su cumbre y su fuente en la Eucaristía, mediante la cual se edifica y crece el pueblo de Dios. And so, my dear sons in Christ, it is your responsibility to assist priests and deacons in carrying out their ministry as a special minister to give Holy Communion to the faithful at the liturgy and to the sick. Because you are specially called to this ministry, you should strive to live more fully by the Lord's sacrifice and to be molded more perfectly in His guidance. You should seek to understand the deep spiritual meaning of what you do, so that you may offer yourselves daily to God as spiritual sacrifices acceptable to Him through Christ Jesus. In performing your ministry, bear in mind that you share the one bread with your brothers and sisters, so you form one body with them. Show a sincere love for Christ's mystical body, God's holy people, and especially for the weak and the sick. Be obedient to the commandment which the Lord gave to His
Please stand. Hermanos, oremos al Señor para que se digne formar con su bendición a quienes se eligió para el ministerio de apóstoles y les dé fuerza para servir siempre con fidelidad a su iglesia. In silence, let us pray for our brothers. God of mercy, to your own Son who entrusted the bread of life to your church, bless our brothers who have been chosen for the ministry of Acolyte. Grant that they may be faithful in the service of your altar and in giving to others the bread of life. May they grow always in faith and love and so build up your church. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated.
Make your life worthy of your service at the table of the Lord and of His church.
take this vessel with bread and wine for the celebration of the Eucharist. Make your life worthy of your service at the table of the Lord and of the Church. Let us congratulate our brothers.
Our brothers may draw closer to Christ and be enabled to witness to Him in the world. Let us pray to the Lord. Para que podamos compartir los problemas y con ello escuchemos la voz del Espíritu Santo, roguemos al Señor. That they may become ministers of the Church, who will strengthen the faith of their brothers and sisters by working in the temple and gather them together to partake of the Eucharist. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Para que envíe trabajadores a su mies y los llene con los dones de su espíritu, roguemos al Señor. That all people may come to the fullness of peace and justice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Para que todos nuestros hermanos afligidos que participan en la pasión de Cristo alcancen la libertad y la salud. Roguemos al Señor.
And let us continue to pray for vocations to the priesthood, religious life, and the diaconate. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Be attentive, Lord, to our prayers for your sons who have been chosen for the ministry of Lector and Acolyte. Grant that your servants may understand and live more fully each day the mystery of your love, so that they can continue to prepare themselves for the sacred ministry of the Church and devote themselves to the salvation of their brothers and sisters for the glory of your name. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
For the Lord accepts the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all of his holy church.
Padre Santo, cuyo Hijo quiso lavar los pies de los discípulos para darnos ejemplo, recibe los dones que te presentamos, y haz que al ofrecernos como oblación espiritual, podamos crecer en el espíritu de humildad y entrega, por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amén.
The Lord be with you.
And
with
your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Lord of heaven and earth, through Christ our Lord. By your word you created the world and you governed all things in harmony. You gave us the same word made flesh as mediator, and he has spoken your words to us and called us to follow him. He is the way that leads us to you, the truth that sets us free, and the life that fills us with gladness. Through your Son, you gathered men and women whom you made for the glory of your name into one family, redeemed by the blood of Christ and signed by the seal of the Spirit. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all the angels, we proclaim your glory as a joyful celebration we have planned. The mystery of faith.
Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Amen. Señor Jesucristo, que dijiste a tus apóstoles, la paz les dejo, mi paz les doy. No tengas en cuenta nuestros pecados, sino la fe de tu iglesia. Y conforme a tu palabra, concédeme la paz y la unidad, tú que vives y reinas por los siglos de los siglos.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord Jesus be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
replenished with heavenly food and drink, that for the sake of your glory and salvation of believers, they may become faithful as ministers of the gospel, of the sacraments, and of charity. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Again, thank you very much for coming. Our friends and others, some religious people, your friends, but also the location director from Laredo, and Bishop, thank you so much for your love and support in coming. Your sharing, and of course, the message is not that very strong, but that is what we need to take into our heart. That message of love and the Samaritans, but for us as the believers, we need to take it. And as the wish of the Holy Father and all the bishops who will trust and send students here, we will try to do the best and we will not be afraid of all. After the celebration, we invite you to go to the cafeteria and enjoy a little reception with us.
My gratitude to all of you for your presence and your participation. This celebration to your diocese for supporting you, especially for the thanks to the coordinators here and the Diocese School for all that you do, the sacrifice of you and forming our men for priesthood. Thank you all very much. El Señor esté con ustedes.
Con ustedes.
Vamos a orar por la gente. Que la bendición que pedimos con fuerte, Señor, a tus pies. Para que nunca se aparten de tu voluntad y puedan siempre alegrarse con tus beneficios.